All right, and joining us for our next hot copy, we're still on our FDR tribute day. We have Mariel Catbagan, who was a former member of the Malacañang Press Corps during the Ramos administration. Mariel, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen. Glad to be here.
All right. Many members of the press actually talk about their relationship covering former President Fidel V. Ramos. Let's talk about that, because we had a very critical press then. But how did he deal with it, Mariel?
Well, actually, to give you a perspective, during the first 100 days of his presidency, one of his first official acts was to go around the news organization's offices and engage with the, you know, with the officials and the personnel there and the reporters. And I think that set the tone of how he dealt with the media during his time. He engaged us and dealt with us in the highest professional level as possible. And even if there were some adversarial journalists or columnists and critics, there was no one that he banned to cover the palace.
And this is what's interesting, considering he was a military man, one would think that he would insist on having full control with the media. And yet he allowed the free press to flourish.
Yes, that is one of the ironies of his leadership, that someone trained in the profession of arms would embrace fully his civilian role. And I think it's part of his duty as a soldier and as a government official, and part of the EDSA revolution aftermath, to safeguard also democracy. And I think having a free press is a pillar of safeguarding that democracy, Karen.
Mariel, you said no one was banned from the palace then.
That's right.
Right? No networks, nothing was closed then. But I wanted to ask you, how would he deal with stories that he wasn't happy with? When he would be upset with the media, how would he deal with all of you?
Well, there are several things that he did, but one, there were times when he would not summon, but invite members of the media through their media outfits, so reporters, kunyari, of PTV, GMA, or the Inquirer. He would invite in an intimate lunch, and we will discuss issues without laying blame on anyone. Or as is his wont, he would during a press conference, he would have them live every Wednesday. He would flash a clipping with his marginal notes, but he will fold the masthead. So as not to embarrass naman the reporter who wrote it, and address the issues as such. That's how he dealt with it.
That's a good one. Tapos nabasa ko nga na kapag galit siya, hindi binaba ng media, ini-invite magkape.
Ganon. Yeah, he would rather engage with you and explain his point of view, his vision, his program, then berate you in public. That's not his way.
You know, Mariel, you have been a journalist for over 30 years. You've covered so many presidents. You've seen it all. Why do you think is the press speaking out in nostalgia for FDR? I mean, it's not often, not all members of the press would do this when a president passes away, but particularly this particular president, a lot of you have been coming out and speaking about him.
That's correct. I think it's because, sorry about this. I think he dealt with us in very professionally. And we know that he appreciated the role of media in nation building. He saw us, and we felt it. He saw us as partners,
not the
rather
enemy.
Than though the nature of the exchange is adversarial. He saw the important role of media in pushing forward the government's programs and his visions for the country. And I think also, this is just my analysis, he's a very keen student of history. And I think that he sees the media as a chronicler and a critic of history. And the narrative that we will write and will be that we wrote then and are now being read now is history. And back then it was history as it happens, and I think that reflects what he was, and he treated us well, didn't pamper us, he treated us as almost equals. So we felt the importance also of our role to tell our people what is happening and why things are happening.
My last question is, you've been quite emotional. There was an interview, you even teared up, but it's because you had a personal relationship with him too after the presidency.
Well, not so much after the presidency, very seldom. But the few times that we were interacting together with him after the press, it was always a poignant but also happy. During his birthdays, he never forgot us. He never forgot to invite us to share in the celebration of his life. I remember in 2017, he had this really big party and we had so much fun. And also, the last time I saw him was in 2019. For the recording of the oral FBR oral history. And see, that continued there, yung his keen sense of history, his place in history. So, and making us part of it, even in the wake that the family recognized the role of media during his presidency, that they allotted a full half day until from 2 p.m. Friday until the wake closed. It really dawned on me how he and the family saw the press, the media.
On that note, Marielle, I want to thank you for joining me today and sharing your insights on this.
My pleasure, Karen.